Hi guys, welcome to this week's tutorial. So this drawing is of a really cute little cow and I decided to name it Tranquility because I thought it would be a really cute little name, and it does have quite a tranquil setting to it as well. So I did the background using inks, just airbrush inks, but you can also use watercolor paints. And then over the background, once it had dried, I used a Uniposco 0.7mm paint marker just to create that cute little design over the top of the surface of the background. And to protect the cow while I did all of this, I applied Friskit to the entire cow so that the paint steered clear of the white area that I was going to draw on for the cow. The cow was drawn with colored pencils, so I used my Prismacolor Premier pencils and my Faber-Castell Polychromos pencils, and I used solvent to blend, and then to add extra highlights over the top, I used the white Uniposco paint marker again. So that's the materials that I used. Oh, and the paper that I used as well was the Archer's watercolor paper. And that is it. So not too many materials required. And oh, and the solvent that I used was the Zestit pencil blend. And that is all that I use for this tutorial. So a couple of things that you're going to learn is how to apply a simple background like this using inks or watercolor paint, and then how to protect your actual drawing while doing a background. You'll also learn the usual things that I like to do in a drawing, and that is how to layer oil and wax based pencils, and how to apply highlights over the top of those layers of pencils, and just how to draw it. So I have a list of colors. It's a small list of colored pencils that I use for the entire cow, which is really handy. So if you just keep these pencils out of your sets, if these are the pencil sets you have, then this is all that you require for this drawing. So let's get into it. Okay, so starting on this cute little cow, I'm going to be doing an underlayer with my Prismacolor marker pens, and then I'm gonna put Friskit over the top so that I can do a ink background, sort of a watercolor thing. Okay, so the four colors that I've picked as an underlayer is a yellowish tone, so they're almost like pastel colors. It's cream, which is PM23, Deco Peach, PM11, Cool Gray, 20%, PM109, and Light Tan, PM95. So I'm just going to use these four colors, nothing else, and I'm going to do an underlayer. And then anything that I feel is going to be really dark and I sort of just need to identify those lines, I'll do that with a pencil. Okay, so I'm going to start off with the lighter tones first using my cream PM23. When applying the Prismacolor markers like this, don't be afraid if you don't quite like the color, because it is easy enough to go over it with our wax and oil based pencils and just enhance or reduce the intensity of the color, or just make it look a little less like markers, I guess. This is purely a simple underlayer so that we don't lose our lines when we apply Friskit over the top. Because one thing I've noticed that when I do apply Friskit over the top of a drawing that I just did in a normal graphite pencil, it tends to lift the graphite off of the paper and then I lose my lines. So this is just an easy way for me to keep the base tones of the entire drawing completely done, and then I can do the details with the pencils, because when you're going to remove the Friskit off of a marker, it's not going to lift anything off of your drawing. So now I'm using the light tan PM95 to create all the brown tones, and then I'm coming in with a cool gray 20% PM109, and then finally I'm using the Deco Peach PM11 for the pinkish tones, and then just enhancing some of the values that I want a little bit darker again with the gray. Okay, now that I have the base colors down just with the markers, I'm going to trace the outline out with this piece of Friskit so that I can protect the drawing when I do the ink background. Okay, now that I have the Friskit protecting the cow, I am going to use these inks. So they are just some colors from my airbrush inks. And I have these watercolor brushes which have the water inside them. So I'm going to apply water and then apply ink and sort of hope for the best. The thing with using watercolors or inks is that it's unpredictable, especially with the method I'm going to be using here. So I'm just going to play around. I do know that I want green and yellow sort of in the bottom section, and then it sort of goes into a bluish kind of illusion of a sky. So I'm going to play around with the greens and the yellows and the blues and the greens, or the blues and the yellows make green, so all these colors should hopefully be a good combination. So I'm just going to get these out of the way, but at least you know what I'm using. Okay, so I'm using this fairly fat brush. So this is the biggest brush that I have out of the set. And I think I'm just going to add blobs of water. And I'm just going to let the color of the ink sort of flow into it. Okay, so I'm going to just dip my brush in the green ink, just like that, and drop some of it into the water. I actually really like the effect that's giving off. And then on a paper towel, if you need to get any of the excess ink off, you just press some water out until the brush is clean, and then you can dip it into the next color. So I want to add some yellow. Just to give it a little bit of a variety. Might even add a little bit of orange. And then I want to use a spray bottle to spread it a little more, but I need to go and fetch it. Okay, now I have a little spray bottle like this, and I'm going to see if it will perhaps just spread out a little. So I have my watercolor paper firmly stuck to my board using masking tape, so it should dry flat. So I'm just picking up any excess that's pooling a bit too much for my liking. And then I'm just going to keep adding some color. I'm going to take a tissue and just dab off some of this. I just pulled way too much. So I'm literally just going to play around with the colours like this and sort of just see where it takes me. I might even add a smidgen of blue. Some of the areas that I think could use more shadow. Make sure you watch the inks around the frisket, because sometimes the frisket can lift a little and then it goes in underneath, and then it's very hard to fix that. Okay, so now we're at the point where the background's dry and I want to apply a nice pattern over the top using my Uniposco white paint marker. So this is a 0.7 mm paint marker, so it's got a nice fine point. And I love the opaqueness of this drawing. The opacity is really strong and the flow is always good. It doesn't get really blotchy, so it doesn't like overflow with big clumps of paint, and it also doesn't dry out. So it's at least a nice consistent flow of a pen, which makes it so nice to use because you're not trying to actually force the ink to get out with the struggle. So I'm just using any random little patterns. I'm using some patterns for the illusion of birds, and then I'm gonna use a pattern for the sky. And sort of just going with whatever comes to mind. I'm also creating little clouds and just putting little random patterns in there. And because the sky is so light, it does create a nice subtle contrast against the patterns that I'm using, so the patterns aren't too overwhelming. Now we finally get into adding our colored pencils to the cute cow. So to the left is a list of all the colors, and that is all the colors I use for this entire drawing. So right now I am using the Black Raspberry PC1095, and just the areas around the eye I'm creating that darker tone, and then I add a bit of the burnt ochre and some of the ginger root. So I'm just gonna pretty much continue doing it this way. And if you create a little chart of these colors and then compare it to your reference, it'll be easy to identify where these colors go on your reference. Plus, it doesn't have to be exact. You can change the colors up a little bit. It's not a problem at all. So for those fine little hairs, I did use my Prismacolor white pencil to push them out over the top of the markers. So that's the beauty about when you're using a marker underlay like this, you can go over it quite easy with wax pencils using both darker and lighter colors. So I'm just going to continue focusing on my reference picture and just build up these colors. So the snout of the cow, you have to pay a little more attention to, because it sort of messes with your head a tiny bit, because the one nostril seems like it's so much bigger than the other one. But the nostril to the left just has a lot more light on it, so it doesn't look as large. And also, I think the bigger nostril is a little closer than the other one, so it is slightly larger than the other nostril. So with the ear, I'm putting some of the darker values down, and then in between I'll come in with the lighter colors and blend it with solvent. I use my zested solvent, and then it's so easy that when you blend like this, you can use your wax-based pencils to create the lighter colors over the top of the darker colors, just to give it more texture and realism. The snout is quite a bit wrinkly, so I'm just paying attention to the wrinkles, trying to make sure that there are quite a few highlighted bits, and focusing on the color variations. There's a bit of this greenish tone in there. And there's also tiny little hairs around the sides of the snout. So using my white wax-based pencil, I'm able to just create some bits a little more highlighted on the snout. The beauty about doing your background first, it is if you've got little whiskers or anything that are sort of in the foreground, it's easy to make that go over the background and make it look three-dimensional. It's not going to look like you've got a solid line as around your main subject against your background, so it won't have that sort of cropped effect. It'll look like it belongs in that background. So I'm doing the same with this ear, putting in the darker tones, and then later on, after I've blended it with solvent, I'll come in with the lighter colors for the little hairs that are a little bit more highlighted. But using my wax-based pencil for the lighter colors, it won't work if you're using oil-based pencils over dark colors. Okay, so now as an extra highlight over those lighter colors that I put over with the lighter Prismacolor pencils, I'm using the Uniposco white paint marker to just create little moist areas on the snout and to enhance the white hairs that I want that's a little bit more to the foreground in front of the ears and the eyes. So this is really gonna make that snout sort of pop out. Now I'm going to start working on the body of the cow. So using my darker tones, I'm just going to build up those values just the same as what I've done with the ears. And then blend it with solvent, and then I could add any lighter areas. It's so nice when you have such a small selection of colors to pick from, so you just sort of get the hang of which colors you require as you go really quickly. You don't have to sort of hunt the colors down when you have a list like that. So you'll see on some parts of the cow's body, I did get some of the ink that bled under the frisket. But that's okay. Luckily, the colors that I want to put over it is darker, so it will cover those ink areas. The right side of the cow as well is more in shadow, so it's going to be a lot darker than the left side. So you can see I'm using the sort of magenta color a lot more on the right side and more of the lighter reddish tones of what I used on the left side. There's a strong area of sunlight on the parts of the cow, so I'm also just making sure to focus on those shapes. When you see me come in with a brush, it's just blending with the solvent. Now you can see how easy it is to come over with the lighter wax-based pencils to enhance any highlighted areas over the darker pencils. Again, you can only do that with wax-based pencils. You can't put lighter oil-based pencils on top of dark colors. And then to enhance the really highlighted areas, I'm using the white paint marker again. There's a few really highlighted hairs on the chin, so I'm still using the paint marker to enhance those. And if you make a mistake with a paint marker, it's quite easy to scratch it off straight away or wipe it off straight away, and then you can just redo it. So I'm pretty much just doing my base layers and blocking areas in and then adding highlights or details over the top after I've blended it with solvent. So the first few layers or the first layer is never detailed, so don't worry about trying to add detail straight away. You want to get a base color in before you add any detail. So we're getting close to the end of the drawing. I'm just making sure that I'm following the reference with the spots and the lighter hair. So as it looks at the as it stands at the moment, the cow sort of looks a bit sunken into the paper. So I just want to add some grass to make it look a little more realistic. Like you can see that his legs are folded over and that they're not just stumped.
Well done on getting to the end of this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did, and I would love to see your results once you have completed it. If you have any questions on more methods of using the inks or the watercolors or blending your pencils or any sort of questions relevant to this drawing to make it a little bit easier, please feel free to ask me on Patreon or ask your fellow patrons on Patreon as well. So thank you guys so much for getting involved in this, and I will see you guys soon. Bye!